Hello everyone, welcome to the presentation. This is Ting Fang Wu from National Taiwan Normal University, Taipei, Taiwan. The topic I'm going to present is developing an accessibility assessment system for mobile device. I have done this work with my colleague Chinong Chu and Huishan Ruo. Chinong Chu is an assistant professor from Department of Information Management, China University of Technology. Huishan Ruo is a doctoral student in Department of Special Education at National Taiwan Normal University. Now we start the presentation. As we know, operating touch screen is much more intuitional and less physical effort than traditional input device, such as keyboards and mice. Therefore, it become popular. According to a survey of eMarket, the population of mobile phone users in Taiwan is about 73.5%. The intuitive operating mode of iPad and iPod can provide a more effective and efficient teaching and learning method compared to the traditional ones. Although there are more and more studies using mobile device to teach, it still needs more some discussion about whether it is suitable for a person with disability. According to a survey by Rehabilitation Engineering Research Center for Wireless Technology from 2012 to 2013, it was found that approximately 40% of people with physical disability only have a simple mobile phone instead of a touchscreen smartphone. The reason might be due to that traditional mobile phones have large buttons, which are easier for person with physical disability to access. And the smartphone with a touchscreen layout usually require more dexterous finger movement to operate. Therefore, this might cause difficulty for person with physical disability. The study also found that person with physical disability have a higher error rate when entering number on the on-screen keyboard than those without disability. Another study also demonstrates that person with physical disability have higher error rate, slower speed, and a longer dwell time when operating the touch screen than people with without disability. From the literature, we can see that people with physical disability have many difficulties in using smartphone, but smartphones are mainstream product and have their advantage in use. Newton, the study, has mentioned that there are two major obstacles for the use of assistive device for person with disability. They are high costs and high abandonment rate. Therapists serving person with physical disability would like to provide accessibility suggestion for them to use mobile phone. Therefore, the purpose of this study was to develop an applicant for mobile device which can simulate the functional task when operating the mobile device touch screen layout. The method we use is developing an assistant. The accessibility assessment system was designed as a cloud-based applicant access through the web to help to the research team. The method. In the method, we develop an applicant called the accessibility assessment system. This system was designed as a cloud-based applicant accessed through the web to help the research team to build, to test, to maintain, to update and scale the accessibility assessment of mobile phone. The web server architecture combines the Apache web server with PHP, Perl, and MariaDB, allowing users to easily connect to the web server with their mobile phone. The design of this system is task-oriented, including three functional tasks. They are tapping, sliding, and dragging. The time to completing of all tasks, error rate of manipulation, correctness of usage, and the size of the finger press area were recorded. In addition, the result of the assessment will be automatically uploaded to the cloud database for further analysis. The result: the system consisted of the three functional tasks, which are tapping, sliding, and dragging. Tap means to point and select the icon on the touch screen of the mobile phone. In the assessment of tap, the size of icon and the area of person is able to access were assessed through the continuous tapping task. Four different modules were designed according to the different size of the icon. For example, the module 5 close 4 means that the layout of the icon on the screen are arranged in 4 columns and 5 rows. The subject will be asked to tap on the flashing icon on the screen continuously, and the time to completing the tapping task, accuracy, and the area of correct tapping were recorded. This slide shows 4 different touch screen layouts. The following slide shows the end result of the tapping task. This slide shows the correct tapping area of the result. The second task was the sliding. The sliding test simulates the action of the person turning the page left or right, or moving the page up and down on the mobile device. In this test, the screen shows 4 arrows in different directions: up, down, left, and right. The subject will be asked to slide from bottom to top, top to bottom, left to right, and right to left on the screen. The accuracy, the time to complete the task, and the trajectory of sliding will be recorded. And the second task was drag. Drag referred to hold the target on the screen and dragging to the specific location. In the drag test, the subject will be asked to drag from blue line on the button to the red line. 4 tasks: dragging from button to top, from top to button, from left to right, and from right to left on the screen were tested. The location where the subject first touched the screen, and the distance and the trajectory of dragging, were, as well as the time to completing, will be recorded. In the discussion, this system has been developed and it seems suitable to evaluate the operating performance of mobile device for person with physical disability. Through the three functional evaluation tasks of the AAS, we would be able to understand the proper icon size and the controllable area of touch screen on their mobile device for the individual with physical disability. For further study, we will test this system with different diagnoses of person with physical disability, including cerebral palsy, spinal cord injury, and muscular dystrophy, to look at their operational performance on the mobile phone. Thank you for your attention. If you have any further questions, please contact me at the following email address. Thank you.
11分钟而已。